30 seconds.
Ma'am, we are live.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is Sanchari Chaudhary reporting live from the IIHM Bangalore Career Studio. I'm extremely humbled today to have with me Ms. Meenu Thognatha, who is a housekeeping divisional head at the ITC Hotels and who comes with a very versatile and rich experience of 40 years with the hotel industry. Meenu ma'am, it's a privilege to have you here today with us. And thank you so much for joining and taking up your very precious time.
Thank you very much. Pleasure is mine too.
Right, ma'am. So to start this conversation, we would like to first know about your journey.
I've been working with industry from past 40 years. I started in 1980 and I started my career with JP Hotels at that time. And after that, I have worked with ITC. I was their management trainee. And from there, we moved on and I worked with Hilton, the hotel, which is now at the moment the Lalit. I also worked for some time in Hyatt and came back to ITC. And in my second tenure also, more than 20 years that I have been with ITC. So I've had a flavor of the city in terms of my career. And I'm blessed with my family. My husband he supports me in my profession. And he's an engineer by profession himself. Right. And both my sons are married. One is an architect, another one is he's into his own business of industrial flooring. And at the same time, both my daughter-in-laws are highly placed, educated, working with PwC as a sustainable architect, and one is a by-profession lawyer. So I'm blessed with a nice family with a grandson. As far as profession is concerned, my journey has been very, very, you know, there are lots of times when it goes up and lots of time when it comes down. But then that's the way it goes with everybody. So has it gone with me as well. But I am overall blessed to be working with a company like ITC, who is always there for their employees and has best practices of the world being adhered to. So I'm with them. Thank you.
That's so lovely. Meenu ma'am, I want to ask you something. You know, by the time you started and you got into the threshold of hotel industry, times were very different. During that time, definitely women used to be, you know, not so familiar with industry, and families also used to be pretty, you know, thinking about how the industry would be. So how was your journey during that time? And was this your first choice itself, or, you know, you thought you can actually try this on and then it became your life and passion? How did it happen?
No, this has been my first job and the last. I have spent my entire career towards hospitality industry only. Yes, right, initially there were hiccups that women joining hospitality and especially hotels industry was being looked at very differently. But nevertheless, as the time progressed, as the world was evolving, as the people were coming more closer, and as the computer age came, and then internet age came, and when people are evolving so much, there wasn't a much of a hurdle in terms of anybody who wants to focus, work with discipline and within the norms. So even the industry people were very, very, you know, nice, and nobody can, you know, sort of give you tough time if you are well prepared in your subject. So whatever you do with dedication and you do it with focus and keeping the challenges in mind, then I think the journey for whether men or women remains the same. And so we kept on progressing. We were ambitious, but not over ambitious. We were confident, but not overconfident. And at the same time, the types who would say, yes, we don't mind trying. We don't mind changing. We don't mind accepting. We don't mind going forward. And so those kind of an attitude, which was positive towards the job, kept us going even in the industry. And that goes for every industry that so says so.
Absolutely.
So as a professional, I grew. As a human also, I grew with the industry.
That's lovely. That is really so inspiring. Ma'am, I have to ask you, I'm certain that in the 40-year span of your career with hotel industry, with the hotels, there might be a lot of such experiences you might have come across, a lot of, you know, hurdles that we were talking about, you know, which had made you more stronger as a professional and as a person. So it would be wonderful, ma'am, if you can just actually account us on a few of them and how did you overcome it?
See, my department has been in a housekeeping department, which is a department of levels, where there's a level 1, 2, 3, 4. So people who are uneducated also are there, people who are semi-educated, people who have passed college and then educated, and then managerial level who comes from very good families and all. So there's been always a very different challenge in terms of handling these levels. And so one had to be really switch off, switch on. And in one moment, you're dealing with a worker. So you have to come down to that level and start speaking like that. And your terminologies have to be different. Your way of talking has to be different. The moment you step up and you're talking to a supervisor, you are talking about different things to him. And similarly, even with the manager. So interaction levels and communication levels, which had to change very frequently up and down with the people, was one of the very, nice challenge, but positive to take it up and have two-way communication. So from the day one, I was very, I kept myself as a professional who is approachable, who can be contacted any moment. And if you come across any kind of difficulty, but irrespective, we are there as a family to look after you. So one has to be a good human first and then become a good professional. So my theory in challenges that have been coming in the industry with the time, where there were time when riots happen in India, in Delhi. I happened to be in the hotel at that day. And for days together, we were just, living in the hotel. Like today, we are living in the at home, quarantined and everything.
Yes, ma'am.
But there were times when we were just as a family who's inside is inside, looking after everybody and taking care. So there comes your own personal touch. If you give your personal touch to your profession, I think you feel more satisfied and you feel more contented and you want to continue with your work as a passion. So I developed my passion and I disciplined it. So when I disciplined it, that is the time when a little bit of challenges start coming. When you are with the family, even with the family, there are times when there are up and down, but then there are some times when VIP movements happening, you can't be with the family. You have to be with the with your team. And so that time complete, help and support comes from your family. They supported me a lot, tremendously. So even domestic help at home was being well looked after and well nurtured, and everybody was like, we had to balance that way. So those balancing that you do between the children growing and becoming professionals, between the house that should be run nicely with empathy and sympathy as well, and even profession should be run the same way. So I had to switch off and on. If I am a professional, I had a different role to play there, but as soon as I come home, I have a different role to play completely. So that was the time when I felt that one should always be humble and very, very approachable and positive to take life ahead, not only profession.
So true, ma'am. Thank you so much for sharing this. This is like very inspiring and so important for all of us, especially our young students who are getting into the industry now and who would be also challenged, getting to see so many challenges. It's very important for them to stay this positive and take ahead this kind of learnings, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. Ma'am, I want to know from you your most, memorable moments during these so many years that you've seen.
Memorable moments are many. But then there are times when I have actually, when you work, you're working with a lot of passion and you are serving to the industry. You are serving to VVIPs. You are serving to all your seniors and working. So every day used to be a different challenge. So we were like looking forward for the day it will come with a new story. So every day is a new story. Every day opens as a new chapter, and we close it and we take forward. And those are the best memorable moments which I have spent with the industry. And I think till today, we take our day as it comes. So memorable moments are many, not one. But then I think I take my every day as a new learning.
Great, ma'am. Ma'am, this is something which is very important, and I'm sure all of our students would want to know this from you. Ma'am, today the world has embraced technology, as we know, and artificial intelligence plays a very pivotal role. How have the properties adapted towards AI culture, and what's the plan for the future, ma'am?
See, I would look at technology is a part of us. Technology is within us. It's family. It's like having your two hands. It's without technology, it is impossible to continue to keep growing the way we are growing. So we adapt technology, and technology becomes part of us. We should not be scared of technology. Technology is a tool to support us in whatever we are doing. And AI, this artificial intelligence is also to be looked at it similar way. I mean, it is that, yes, by the way the world is growing, the different challenges coming forward every day, some part of it we have to adapt and accept. Otherwise, it will become very, very, we just cannot be only human oriented. So if technology is there to support. There were days when we were just doing cleaning with hands, and then came the vacuum cleaner. And there were days when came after vacuum cleaner came vacuum mat, when even the water can be, sucked with that. Then came a technology which is robotic. I'm working and he is my support, and he is also working in the corridors and in the room and just doing the cleaning part of it, and is there. Now another way of looking at it is that the kind of laborious works which AI has started to support us with. I would do a physical inventory of 100 things, but today if I have this artificial intelligence apps and everything and support with me, within minutes the inventory can be done. So and at the same time, if I have stored some data and I want to take it and filter it and immediately come up with some kind of a report, I really don't have to depend on 2+2, 4 and 4+7 like that way. I just have to put the the formula, and there it is for me. So it is a kind of a support which is supporting us. You must also understand, and the youngsters must understand, there were times when labor and people were available. Today, everybody is wanting to be educated, and everyone wants to do a white collar job. Very minimal people who want to do laborious work. So if I have technology which is supporting me along with me to take up that big scale job, I'm sure it's a good support. And similarly, we should accept technology and continue to move forward with it. Like checking of rooms, now my measuring of a wall, my for paint and anything. Yes. Everything is based on remote. I mean, today there's a touch button, and you can ask Alexa 100 things. She's playing it for you. There were times when you would be, wanting to hear one music and there is no music. And today, people have world in their hand, in their palm. So internet is available with everybody. So all kind of a technology driven artificial intelligence, whichever it is, should be taken into a positive sense instead of taking it into a fear fiasco that I'm going to fear if robo is going to come up and is going to take up the job. No, robo is a robo. Human is a human. It's not a replacement for human, but it is a replacement for some kind of tasks which can be performed by the machine, and why not? So we support, that way they take the support of these things. And there were times when people would get into the swimming pool to clean the swimming pool. And you know, to filter the dust out and empty it out and do it today, you you know, sort of make the robot swim in. It's a kind of a machine, and it just goes in, does its work, filters everything, comes out, and you really don't have to worry about anything. So we must understand artificial intelligence that it is artificial, first of all. Second is that it is to support you. Third, how do you adapt it and how you look at it? How can you be more than? I mean, there were times when Edward Hillary said to Mount Everest that as a mountain, you cannot go grow, but as a human, I can grow and I'll come back and conquer you. So it is the human tendency, and as a human has a power to overcome all these things and accept them positively. My take to this goes this way.
Completely agreement with you, ma'am. Absolutely accepted. Mm-hmm. Minu, ma'am, we have a lot of our students who definitely are looking for a career in hospitality and definitely also wanting to be in housekeeping and accommodations operation. Ma'am, I would want to basically, you know, want you to in fact go ahead and give them the most important attributes that all of them need to have in them, both personally as well as professionally, and how can they take ahead this career?
See, my message to the youth would be that whatever you want to do, whether you want to take up career in housekeeping, hospitality, banking, anywhere, first is a discipline yourself. Yes. To be a professional. And professional doesn't have a simple definition. It has a definition which is combination of all. That is discipline, focus, attitude, humbleness, and looking forward and continue to keep enhancing your knowledge, your education, your skills, and be on top of it. And so my take to the, my giveaway to the students would be that, first of all, if you want to take up housekeeping as a career in hospitality industry, please look forward. Come with a lot of passion towards it. Don't come thinking it is housekeeping. It is today the housekeeper has to have a knowledge of even chemistry for that matter. She has to know the science of cleaning. She has to know the science of understanding textiles. She has to understand that what are the type of amenities and ingredients that go into it? How does a thing get formed? And what are the best usages of it? So number of textiles, number of fabrics, number of leather material, soft, hard flooring, everything is getting used. Not only to maintain it, but also to how to support in terms of even procuring. Then comes the how do you connect with your customers? So you have to have a proper good communication skills to be able to impress your customer, to be able to impress your guest and connect with them and understand them and give them what is required to be, you know, delivered and delivered intelligently, as we said. That, and at the same time, they should be a frontline housekeeping managers who are there to support the system, who have the business mind, who know that if I need to control the cost, then I need to control the cost. This is the time where I need to spend the money. This is where I cannot compromise on quality. So she is a quality leader. She is a cleaning champion. She is a frontline manager. She's a right. business model. So a lot of all these abilities have to be there in a person to be able to hold the profession. Whichever profession you are in, housekeeping or for that matter, front office or F&B, that positive attitude of yours towards your own work and towards your own self, that I need to grow with the industry, will definitely take you forward. Yes, challenges like what we are seeing now today, COVID.
Yes,
we have seen the challenges in the past where recession was there. Right. There were economic downs. There were kind of government, this thing, ups and downs, wherever sometime it becomes environmental issue, sometime it becomes political issue, sometime it becomes social issue or personal issue. These things keep happening in our life. These things make us stronger. At this moment also, when students who are passing out, who cannot join industry because industry is passing through a different phase altogether, yes, can always afford to educate themselves for one more year. Take up some nice master courses, take up some language courses, take up some courses of, you know, being personality development, some kind of a grooming where they groom themselves and make ready for the industry to, you know, accept them. So instead of feeling that, you know, what is going to happen to me in nothing, if the jobs don't come up, what will happen, where will I work and all that. Say, okay, this storm has come. I am going to make some my best use of my time. I'm not going to waste it on so many other things or by just thinking and, you know, I will take action. This was my passion I always wanted to do. Or this is something which is going to add value to my, you know, profession. And by being single department person, I may not be able to grow, so I should have the multi-skilling.
Yes.
I should take up a course of, now let's say, front office. I can always go to understand F&B.
True.
I can always understand spa and the, you know, the facilities that are given in the health clubs and gyms. So I become confident and educated to handle instead of one, two departments. I take up some nice courses and all and add value when God has given me this time and then move on further to the industry with more caliber. And the industry then looks at you that, look at the positive attitude this child has when even that such tough times were ahead and he has stood by it and is now coming back to us in 2021 or 22 or 23. Now we should accept such your youth who is fighting their battle instead of feeling, you know, the pinch of the situation. So that's my message to them, that stay calm, stay confident, keep yourself positive, think of positive things, do something which is going to add value to you, and definitely things will come your way. But don't get hassled with the situation. That's my take to the subject.
Ma'am, so true, because exactly just as you said, ma'am, it is so important for every individual today, every student. In fact, you know, getting into the world of hospitality to be an all-rounder, they cannot really devote into just one particular unit or department. They have to be multi-skilled. So I'm very certain that all our students today who are watching you live here, and especially our graduating batch of 2020, who would be getting into the industry very soon, you know, in spite of all the hurdles that COVID has basically brought into the situation, still to maintain that calm, be patient, just like you have said, ma'am, and definitely be very, very positive of the situation that no matter what, hospitality industry will always grow and grow. Right, ma'am? I think.
Definitely. So I would just say, add one more thing, that today when you get chance to work somewhere, always don't think of encashing. Right. Don't think of encashing. Just think of experience. That even if someone wants me to come and work and not pay me so much and just pay me stipend or token money or little bit,
correct,
I am more than willing to go and work because it is going to give me an experience today, make me able to, you know, make my image in front of my seniors and in front of the industry, which will add value to my CV. And I can definitely, when nice times will come, will grow. Everybody is good. Those who are on the this side of the table and those who are on the other side of the table. True. Now, when you are on the other side of the table, you don't want to harm young people. You want to adopt them. You want to bring them into your culture and develop them. But even you have your hands tied. But at the same time, the person who's on the other side of the table is also very understanding that, yes, I understand what situations are, what is the industry going through. So I'm also going to go with the wind and with the storm and not against that. So I'll definitely be one of the ones who will be able to survive through this period as well.
Thank you so much, Meenu ma'am. It is such a pleasure to have you here today. And with such inspiring words and so much of confidence that you've in fact gone ahead and given to all our students of IIHM Pan India who is watching you today, that has been excellent, ma'am. Thank you so much for your time and definitely for all your support forever, for all the time
Thank
that you always give us, ma'am. That's amazing. Please
Thank
stay
you very
healthy.
Much.
Pleasure, ma'am.
Thank
and
you.
We shall be seeing you very soon in Bangalore campus again. Take
Definitely.
Care, ma'am.
Yeah, stay connected, stay safe. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Have a great day and have a great afternoon, everybody. Thank you so much
Thank
for
you.
Watching us.
Thank you.